Hi, Pastor Bill. Bethel Evangelical Lutheran Church, we're located in Green Valley. And today's the 5th of March, right, Noah? It's Friday, and that means it's time for Friday Funnies. What do you have for us?
Did you ever hear the joke about the roof?
Joke about the roof? I didn't know you could make a joke about... I never heard the joke about the roof.
Never mind, it's over your head.
Thanks. Got another one?
What was the snake's best subject in school?
I've never seen a snake slither into a school. I don't know. What was its best subject?
History.
Thank you, Noah.
Get something in your head. It's nothing you heard or something you read. Ever had a cup but you never saw them play. Brought to your knees but you never prayed. Jesus in disguise, Jehovah passing by.
Please pray with me. Lord, all that we are, all that we ever will be, is because of your graciousness. Have mercy upon your people. Give us your love always, we pray. Amen. And our text for this Friday is Acts chapter 7, verses 30 through 40. And we take a step into the Old Testament in the book of Acts. 40 years later, an angel appeared to Moses in the flame of a burning bush in the wilderness near Mount Sinai. Enthralled by the sight, Moses approached to get a closer look, and he heard the Lord's voice. "I am the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." Trembling with fear, Moses didn't dare to investigate any further. The Lord continued, "Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. I have clearly seen the oppression my people have experienced in Egypt, and I have heard their groaning. I have come down to rescue them. Come, I am sending you to Egypt." This is the same Moses whom they rejected when they asked, "Who appointed you as our leader and judge?" This is the Moses whom God sent as leader and deliverer. God did this with the help of the angel, who appeared before him in the bush. This man led them out after he performed wonders and signs in Egypt, at the Red Sea, and for 40 years in the wilderness. This is the Moses who told the Israelites, "God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your own people." This is the one who was in the assembly in the wilderness with our ancestors and with the angel who spoke to him on Mount Sinai. He is the one who received life-giving words to give to us. He's also the one whom our ancestors refused to obey. Instead, they pushed him aside, and in their thoughts and desires, returned to Egypt. They told Aaron, "Make us gods that will lead us. As for this Moses who led us out of Egypt, we don't know what's happened to him." Here ends our reading. Some Old Testament background. This occurrence that's being described takes place while Moses is on Mount Sinai, and he's there receiving the law, receiving the Ten Commandments. And the people are becoming very frustrated. They're impatient. And so they speak to Aaron, who's the high priest of the people. He says, we're tired of waiting for Moses. We need you to make for us the God that took us out of Egypt. And so they gather together their earrings and various jewelry, and Aaron creates a golden calf. And they worship this golden calf. What they wanted to do, what they felt the need to do, was to worship something of themselves. That's what the golden calf represented. It was a representation of themselves. And they were pointing to it and saying, "This is how we got out of Egypt. We did it." And the truth of the matter is, the force that brought them out of Egypt was meeting with Moses at that time. The words in Acts talk about Moses being rejected. And this reflects well with the reading that we had yesterday, Thursday. That reading was from 1 Peter. And it talks about Jesus being the cornerstone of the building, the very corner of our faith. And the people rejected Jesus way too quickly. Too quickly, they sought out his crucifixion. And in the same way, Moses is their leader in the wilderness, and they're rejecting him. They're rejecting their leader who is so necessary for their survival. Moses wasn't the Savior. Moses certainly wasn't Jesus. But Moses was indeed their conduit, their connection with God. He was leading them according to the Spirit of God. In our lives, Jesus leads us. Christ is the conduit. Christ is the leader who takes us through our turmoils, through our challenges, out of our sinfulness as we are forgiven through the cross. It is Jesus who calls us from that high tower on Mount Calvary. And there he proclaims once and for all his victory. And it's that victory that we take part in. Amen. Please pray with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. May God's will guide you and keep you.